So hello everyone, today I am back with another video. So in this video I'd like to share how you can easily clone a page and using PageFly, and it's very easy. I will show you every step one by one. So for color option, I would like to prefer this extension color color picker, and for font I am using this extension. It's very easy to get the size, line and the font family as well as color. And for the image, sometimes if you save the image, like it will show in webp. So for reducing this one, I am using another extension, this one, and when you will save, it will show in jpg. So I am using this three extension most. You can see all the extension here, and color picker, eyedropper, and what font, find font, and for the save one, image download extension, all our Chrome extension. Basically I am using this. So here you can see a page, very small but clean one. I am going to clone this page. The whole video you can easily see what actually I am doing. Okay, now let's start. So first of all, you can see that there is two section. In the left section there is a product image, and there are access to all the like information. So here we will go. First we will take a product details here, then we will add a product. Basically we have only one product, so we are going to add this one. Yep. Now what we will need to do, we will need to add our reviews, custom reviews, because and here is the block. Take a block, click here for icon, and I'll pick icon here. For the color, I'm using the extension under other monitor. So here is the color. Okay, and also I will add the, we can easily add the size as well if we want to add. So color done. Now it's time to add size 17. Sorry, 17. And here add 3. We get all the 5 star. So here you done, it's done. Now we need to add text. So for the text, I'll take paragraph and yeah. Now it's time to add text. I think very in the first very beginning of the video I showed how actually I'm going to clone, so I'm not showing every page again and again. And alignment, center. What you will need to do is add a margin, and one thing that we'll need to add our font. So let's see what actually we are using in our website, which font basically we are. So basically we are using a font. Let's take this font family from other page, so it will not take time. So this one is Oops. Okay, forget about that. Scope one. So let's try to add in. Scope. We don't have one, so we'd like to use this scopes. And for this one, here it is. So it's now time to add our so here you can see the price. It will be the design. Here you can see that now you can add one thing if you want very easily. Another one. So we'll need to do one thing. We'll need to so here you can see that I need to add we'll need to take background color and save copy dollar. You can easily count. -9.95, so it will save 3.05, maybe something like that. Yeah. So here is the things that are done with that. Now click save. Okay, we are going to add a I'm giving you it's save. So it's something like that. Now what you will need to do, you will need to add a header. And it will be Black Friday sale, and something like that, 20, and save. Now we are going to add loading ipsum. And we'll keep that 70 and 98 would be 30. Yeah, that's it. Now what you need to do, you need to add a list, but for now I think we are not going to add that. We'll add a block. Okay, and in the block we'll use emails. So save. Now we'll need to do one thing. I'll need to add the variations. And now it's time to add the variations. So basically, product variation basically comes from here. Horizontal variation and I would like to keep that. Yeah, one thing I like that should save. Now click view. Basically there is no base. I don't know why. Let's see, this is also a tip. And oh yeah, I am doing this wrong. We need to put one custom, then it will show in the preview one. And one thing I realized that we should increase this at least 20, and then it will show. And also I like to use here text a little bit. SIB. One thing we should do.
Silver color, yet.